Welcome to another OpenLab screencast. My name is Olivia, I use she/her pronouns, and I'm a digital pedagogy fellow on the OpenLab community team. In this series, I'll be guiding you through the basic building blocks that go into every OpenLab site, whether you're creating a site for a class, a club, a personal portfolio, or another project. In this video, I'll show you how to create and edit pages and posts. In other videos, I'll show you how to customize other site building blocks and show you where they appear on your site. For this video, I'll be using the default WordPress theme for creating a course. If you decide to change your theme, it will simply rearrange the building blocks you already have into the new design. The default content on the site will also look a little different if you're creating a project, club, or portfolio, but the same principles will apply to every type of site on the OpenLab, so don't worry if yours looks a little bit different. Additionally, all of the directions I'm going to say, such as left, right, top, and bottom, are assuming you are editing your site on a computer. You can still edit on your phone or on a tablet, but some things may appear in slightly different places. Here we are on the front end of your site, the part that is visible to the public. Now let's visit the back end of our site and learn how to edit each of these building blocks. You can access the back end, known as the dashboard, by clicking on the name of your site in the dark gray bar at the top of your browser, or by mousing over it and clicking Dashboard. On the left-hand side of the dashboard, we have a navigation bar that will allow us to edit different aspects of our site. The most important ones when you're just getting started are posts, pages, and appearance. Let's begin with posts and pages, since that's where you'll be putting most of your site's content. Editing posts and editing pages are very similar to each other, but they each serve different purposes on your site. A page is static. It always stays visible and in the same place unless you decide to edit it. In contrast, a post becomes part of your site's blog feed, where the most recent post always automatically appears at the top with older ones below. If you click on either the Posts or Pages button, it will take you to a list of all the posts or pages that currently exist on your site, as well as any unpublished drafts. To edit a post or a page, mouse over the name and then click either one of the edit buttons, or you can click Add New. The block editor and the classic editor use different layouts, but you can use either one to make changes to your site, and we have help documentation for both, so use whichever one you like better. For now, I'll use the block editor. We have another video to introduce you to the block editor in greater detail. I'll put the link to that one in the description, but for now, I'll just add a title and a little bit of text to my post. When you're done making changes, make sure to click on the blue button in the right-hand sidebar. If you're editing an existing page, it will say Update. And if you're creating a new page or post, it will say Publish. If you're done for now, but not ready to publish, you can always click Save Draft. When editing a post, you can also use the right-hand sidebar to add categories and tags, but we'll be covering those in detail in another video. Now you know how to create or edit pages and posts on your site. For more information, you can check out our other videos or our written help documentation. I'll put a link in the description. Thanks for joining me today.